Ricky Ross, Boss, T-Pain. I got a fresh lineup, yeah, a fresh outfit. About to have a parking lot on smash. Plus I got a Chevy with a 454 in the hood. 125 on the dash.
I'm the biggest boss that you seen thus far. I'm the biggest boss that you seen thus far. I'm the biggest boss that you seen thus far.
Cause it's just another day in the life of the. Okay. Now, the first thing you want to do, as far as the PDI goes, is you want to remove all the screws on the scooter. Now, basically, what the website says you want to do is have a bunch of these little plastic bags, so you can put all the screws and tape them to the parts of the bike that you take them out from. Try to make a pile of screws, you're not gonna remember what goes where, because there's virtually probably over 100 different screws on here. So make sure you grab your little baggies. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and start from the top of here and make my way down. So even just right here on the side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, there's 9 screws just on there. So hopefully this whole part, basically when all the screws are out, will kind of lift on up. So once we get there, I'll go ahead and let you guys see what happens once we get all these screws out. Now, if you can see right here, this is one of the panels that obviously, if you go ahead and take the screw out of that panel, you can see that you have some access to some wires on the inside. So again, if you have to do some maintenance on the bike while driving, it shuts down for you. But as you can see, for example, these are a lot of the pieces we're going to be checking
right
on.
Here
is what they have in the PDI. You want to go ahead and on these are some that you're going to want to go ahead and silicone and make sure are on there, because again, they could be loose. But this is the inside. As you can see, it's actually pretty nice looking in here. I don't see any signs or anything bad, but we'll see once we get this whole thing off. Now, another thing they tell you should do is go ahead and tape the screws to the pieces you take off. So these are the screws that are going on the main section right there. And also, this is what you want to have. You want to make sure that you take pictures of every section that you take apart. That way, at the very end, really all you have to do is go backwards on your photo slide and put it back together exactly the way you took it apart. So remember, a camera, and remember you want to tape the screws, put them in a little Gladlock bag, and go ahead and put them on the pieces. Okay, and as you can see, we have now removed the middle console. So again, you have your I think that's the coolant, and over here you have the gas tank. Again, more wires exposed. Again, we're going to be checking all those ends, but again, surprisingly, everything does look pretty crisp, pretty good underneath in here. So we still got a lot of ways to go, but again, it only took me about 15-20 minutes to go ahead and take the screws off of this section. And then over here we have the trunk. Again, you can see we have the screws taped to there. And then over here, also one thing that you can do is if, say, some of the screws are specific, like this one had 2 black screws, so putting it in the bag with the same section wouldn't really do any good. So I just went ahead and taped those right to where they go. That way, when it's time to put it back in, you don't have a bag of screws and not know what goes where. The whole front part removed at this point. So again, we've got the trunk, the main part that covers where the gas area goes, the very front of the scooter, and then we have the main part that goes right here in the middle. So again, the key is to try to tape the screws to the parts. Interestingly enough, inside of here there was like a random piece of tape on the inside, so I guess I'll have to replace that. But as you can see, we go around, you can kind of see now you have access to all the electrical aspects of it. So if say you're gonna go ahead and update or upgrade like a horn or any kind of alarm system, this is how you would take it apart. So we'll be checking all of the joints and everything in here. So we really only have one more part to remove. That'll be this back part here. And then we can go ahead and start our official PDI process. And as it gets later, more starts to come off. I've now taken the trunk off. And as you can see, because this back part was a little difficult, these black caps here actually conceal more screws. So what I'm noticing is that, yeah, you start to lose track of screws real quick because there were so many. So again, once we get these off, we should be able to lift the back part and then have a completed removal of the scooter. So remember, the key is to just keep track of everything. I've basically taken pictures the whole way through to kind of document, so I'm gonna go ahead and work completely backwards when it's time to reassemble. But that won't be till later, because after we check all the screws, then we'll have to do fuses and fluid. So we'll go ahead and show you once we get this final back part off. Okay, now the most difficult part to take off is the back. Now as you see, we got the back off on this side. What'll happen is when you try to take the back off, it'll seem that it's stuck on there. So just know you don't really have to, unless you want to take this middle console part out, then you can take these screws out. But the back actually is in three pieces. You've got your floorboard piece here, which is all one. This connects up here and goes up. And then your side paneling. Then you've got your side panel here. It goes right at the bottom. Remember, keep track of your screws. And then you've got your back part here. Now remember, here you have to pay attention because you have to unfasten this from here, because as you can see, both sides. This one we kind of left on because it's hooked up to the engine, or actually the gas tank. So we didn't want to unhook the wire for that. But as you can see up here, it actually unfastens. So you have to unclamp that, and then you can pull this side off, because when you first try to do it, it'll seem like it's one whole piece. But yeah, you got to make sure that you unclamp that. So for the most part, this is the most we're going to disassemble it, because most of the stuff you can kind of, you can't get access to it up there. You can get access to it on the side, so you can see it's an integral type of thing. So basically the next part will be to go through, and these are the type of screws that you get. These are all throughout the bike. Some vary in length. Most of them are about the same, but some are darker than others. And these are the things that you're going to want to go ahead and make sure that you silicone close and kind of clamp them together. So these are all over the bike. So yeah, so like I said, most important thing again, kind of stay semi organized as far as where your pieces are. We left the back pieces kind of towards the back, the front pieces towards the front. And definitely when you reassemble, go backwards. So of course we're going to put the back on first, and we're going to end with the middle console. So again, we'll go ahead and in the detail kind of show you what you want to do as far as clamping and putting the silicone pieces on the clamps.